My research focuses on colorism in Latin American media, and especially in Mexican mass media. Colorism is the bias against darker skin tones and in favor of lighter skin tones. It can manifest in different ways. One of the most evident ways is direct behaviors of discrimination, but other ways in which it can manifest can be more subtle. And I'm also interested in looking at how colorism may influence outcomes, like for example, electoral contests. So currently I'm working on a project that analyzes candidates' skin tones in the 2021 election, and it looks at how different colors may predict the success of the candidates. Here I'm using an algorithm that classifies skin color. So I'm using a few pictures from candidates of the 2021 election in Mexico. And what the algorithm does is it identifies the face in the picture, and then it identifies the dominant color in the face. And in the bottom, we can see the percentage of the identified color, as well as the skin tone classification and the accuracy. In Mexico, productions of entertainment and just general media representations are very homogeneous in the sense that they present mainly white or light-skinned people. So I think one simple, relatively simple way in which we can help solve the problem of colorism is simply representing more brown and dark-skinned people in fiction and in non-fiction as well. And that takes effort in the sense that we have to convince the people who create content that this can actually make a change and that is important and that the choices they make have an impact on their audience. But I think it's something possible and a tangible goal. The average person should care about colorism because it is an issue that exists in, I would dare to say, every single culture. And the general public is not really aware of it. So if people become more aware and know how the issue works, then they can improve the way they interact with their peers and just ultimately help mitigate the prevalence of bias in the way we interact with each other.